on Ricki Lake.
This fun Friday! We have Jamie Foxx in the house!
He's a new Baywatch babe, Michael Bergin.
Can I see more?
Easier life is once that starts happening. I'm real happy to be here, and I'm really excited about today's show. Before we get started, I know you guys are getting yourselves ready and pumped. Anybody have anything they want to say to me before we go? Yeah, you want to ask me something? Why don't you head on over to that mic? Hi, ma'am.
Hi, Ricki.
Hi.
Ricki, tell me, if you wasn't married, what movie star actor would you like to go out with or make love to?
Are you trying to get me in trouble? Because let me just tell you, normally my husband does not watch the show. He lives with me. He doesn't need to see me doing what I do. But right now he's in the makeup room getting a haircut by Mary, my hairdresser. And so he's listening right now, and he knows the answer to this question. LL Cool J. Gonna be sleeping through the night tonight. That would be me, because I'm gonna be taking a lot of flack from that. Sorry, honey. Anything else I gotta get off the chest? Yes. Hi there. Yeah, what do you want to ask me? Hi, sir.
Ricki. I just gotta know, do you prefer a bath or a shower?
All right. Well,
if I may.
No need to get the visual here, okay? When I have the time, I'm a bath kind of gal.
That's what I thought.
You thought that. Exactly. All right, but don't picture it, okay? Do me a favor. All right, thank you. Enough about me. Shall we get on with the show? Let me just tell you guys, someone in our audience is going to win a honeymoon trip today during this hour. And we also have a great celebrity lineup for you. We have Jamie Foxx in the house. I'm very excited. He's a new Baywatch babe. Michael Bergin is here. And we have another exciting guest here today. Listen to this music, shall we? That's right. Diana King is here. Don't go away. There's a lot more to come. Stay with us for Fun Friday. Your weekend. Now, we know how to start a party, and there is no one to kick it off like the hilarious and sensational star of his own highly rated sitcom. Please welcome the one and only Jamie Foxx.
A little.
little help here.
How you doing?
Nice to see you. Welcome back. I'm very happy to see you.
Congratulations.
Thanks. Oh, yeah. Last time I saw you, yeah. Now I'm not as. I'm just a little.
Looking good, girl.
Thank you. So are you. And you've been very busy since we last saw you. You've made a few movies.
Yeah, made a movie.
You want to talk about it? Booty Call.
Yeah.
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 I think we saw all of you in that movie.
Yeah, I was kind of naked. I was naked. As a matter of fact, I know you know Vivica Foxx, beautiful Vivica Foxx. Look at that. Look at him back there. Yeah, where she at?
Yeah, you're jealous, aren't you? He was naked with her.
I was naked with Vivica Foxx, which was kind of, that's hard. That's hard to do.
What do you mean it's hard to do?
It's just very hard. I mean, you know, it's hard.
That too.
I mean, yeah, that too. But no, I mean, when you're working and you're trying to be professional and, you know, and I got a G-string on, basically. They give you, you're not all the way naked. They give you a little G-string.
Right. It's the color of your skin.
Yeah, it's like a pickle holder, whatever they call it. So, anyway, she's sitting on top of me for like hours at a time.
And they're asking you to act natural.
And they're asking me to act natural. Now, the natural thing is... You know what the natural thing is. You guys are, everybody's doing that. But then they were like, you know, act natural, let's be professional. And I was like, well, let's hurry up before I lose my professionalism. And then they were like, you know, cut, and then I'd have to go and get myself together, get in touch with myself.
Right.
A couple
your
of cigarettes.
Self.
Yeah, my natural self, something like that. But
so it was really hard work, is what you're saying.
It was hard work, and then, like, you know, we got a little flack from, you know, because it was Booty Call, you know, they got
right.
a little flack from, I think Bill Cosby was upset that we did Booty Call. I just don't like, you know, the title, and it's just, you know, filth and flying and flooring and what have you, and it's kind of rough when, because I think he said in USA Today that whoever did Booty Call should have looked in the one as, you know, before they did it. It was kind of rough. And then not too long after that, there were some accusations about Bill in the news. And I was like, wow, I guess he's been doing some booty calls too. But anyways.
So you don't regret making this film?
No, I don't regret. I mean, it was just a lot of fun. You know, we were having a good time and everything.
A lot of natural professionalism
happening. And with Tommy Davis and Vivica Foxx and Tamela Jones had a great time. And, you know, that was that.
That's great. And how's the show going?
Well, the show is going great.
It's the highest rated show on WB Network.
I'd like to thank the fans for that.
Yeah.
Thank you. It's a very fun show. I'm sure you've all seen it and everything like that. And the fact that it's set inside a hotel, anybody could come into the hotel at any time. We're moving to Sunday nights now, so you make sure you catch it because that's when all the people, are, you know, the most of the people in the world are watching TV. So we'll be on Sundays at 8. And we got a brand new character that's called Enrique, who's going to be on there doing.
And that would
thing.
Be you?
That'll be me. I'm doing this character. He's the Lord of Merengue, and they have a hip hop contest at the hotel, and he enters it and wins and everything like that. So we just want everybody, you know, to check it out.
That sounds great. Now I understand you're Jamie Foxx, but you're not really Jamie Foxx.
Yeah, I was Eric Bishop. Actually, was my real name when I was starting out, like doing stand up or whatever. I couldn't get on. After I went on as Eric Bishop, you know, they was like trying to, you know, freeze me out. So they would always need women to go on the show, on the like the amateur nights. And so you just write your name down. And I wrote all of these unisex names, Stacy, Tracy, and Jamie, and they chose Jamie. Is she here? And I was like, yo, bro, right over here.
And so it just stuck.
Just stuck. And so I stuck with Jamie Foxx, and then I did this whole promotional thing myself with, like, you know, be a part of the Foxhole, slides of Foxx, all this other kind of stuff. And then from there on, went to Living Color, did my thing with the Wanda, the whole nine, and that, and then getting to my own show and just having the ball with.
Do you keep in touch with the people from In Living Color?
As a matter of fact, no, I don't.
You don't?
Doing their own thing, you know, Jim Carrey.
Keenan, you don't talk to Keenan,
well,
Damon.
You know, I see them out and everything, but they're working and everything, and I'm trying to get them on my show, you know, to boost their careers. I mean, you know.
nice of you.
Well, you know, Jim Carrey's kind of doing bad and everything, not making a lot of money, so I was thinking maybe he want to come do my show, maybe. But, you know, I see him.
Hey, if you get him on your show, would you put in the good word for us?
I would definitely. Okay. If I can get him on the show, that'll be a plus.
That'd be great. A plus for us, too. That would be great. All right. We'll both go over his house and
knock him over the head.
Okay.
Hey, what's going on? Who's... No, I'm just kidding.
Now, is it true that you got your start in the working world at Tom McCann?
Selling shoes, man.
You were Ed Bundy.
Yeah, I was basically, hey, pick Ed Bundy. From Married with Children. But I was good at it, you know, like when women
would come in. Wait, how are you good at selling shoes?
I was just, I do my thing, especially when women would come in. You know, I already knew their size. But the thing about women, they never want their feet to be too big. Like, I would measure their foot, it'd be like a 10.5, 11.
Yeah.
And they'll be like, I wear a 6. I said,
I'm one of those people.
And they always get the sandal, and the toe is like hanging over, and the heel is hanging, and it's like, I'm like,
person. You guys laugh, but do you all do that, ladies?
Yeah, they do that.
And once you get pregnant, you have a baby, your foot grows.
It grows?
It grows. It does.
Yeah.
I used to be a 7.5, but now I think I'm an 8, 8.5
now.
Yeah.
Well, that's cool. You know, you need feet to stand on. Sometimes they get the shoe, and like I said, the sandals too, so Sparks is flying because they get the nails done and everything like that. But I started out selling shoes, and then went from there to doing my thing.
Wow, what a great transition.
Yeah.
Well, you want to check out some shoes in our audience? You're the pro, huh?
Well, I see some kind of beat up. I need to come out and sell some.
All right, maybe during the commercial break you can check and see who's got the right stuff.
What size are you?
What size are you, ma'am?
10.
Are you lying? Are you really a 10?
She's like, I wear a size 10.
All right, we'll check out your feet during the break. Coming up later in the show, we have Baywatch's Michael Bergin and hitmaker Diana King with her latest smash from My Best Friend's Wedding, I Say a Little Prayer. But when we come back, we're going to get personal with Jamie Foxx. Get ready, honey.
Okay.
As our audience asked him about the things that you want to know.
Uh-oh.
We'll be right back.
Merengue, Lord of the Merengue. You merengue, no?
Oh, no.
No!
No!
James!
Yes!
We do it! My hand! 4, 5, 6, 1! Duh! Your leg.
Oh,
your
leg back. My back.
Your back?
Yeah.
And also, I misused later on. I misused you. No?
No.
No?
No.
Okay. Join us. Excuse me. That's a merengue, no? Who put this bar here? Oh, I must go under it.
It is packed. Me and my mother are going to turn this one out.
Mm-hmm. But you know, Jamie, it's getting kind of late. Maybe you should come up with a backup plan.
Oh, I didn't know you wanted to sing backup. I'll go, here, step right here. Supremes, supreme it, Marvelettes, Diana Ross. Don't touch me, don't touch me, don't touch me. Don't touch me. Security.
Jamie Foxx show, and we are talking with the funny guy, sitcom star, the man, Jamie Foxx.
Peace. Now,
little bird whispered right here and told me that you came this close to the Cuba Gooding Jr.
Man.
Part in Jerry Maguire. What happened?
Man, I was robbed. I was robbed. No, I came out to read the movie with Tom Cruise. Because Tom Cruise wasn't on board with the project, so they needed somebody to read the part that Cuba Gooding played. So I'm reading the part and everything, you know, thinking I'm in. But I mean, it was funny when I met Tom Cruise because it was like, you know, it was a little tension. So I was trying to let him know, you know, I got fans too, you know. And so it was like a battle of the egos a little bit. And I was trying to let him know that, you know, I got a house in Vegas and a house in L.A., you know, I'm big balling, you know.
So you're not selling shoes no
more?
Yeah,
I ain't selling shoes. And then I said, so where do you live? And he said, Rome. I was like, Rome Street? You know, like Rome, Italy. I said, yeah, well, that's cool, that's cool. But, you know, breaking the ice and everything, and I thought I was in on it. But, you know, Cuba did a great job.
Yeah, he was all right, huh?
Yeah, he was all right. You know, he was cool.
I know we have tons of people
I came up with show me. I said,
maybe
show me your income.
Maybe he learned some things from you.
Huh?
Maybe he learned some things from you.
Exactly. It's all me.
Yes.
Hi, I just wanted to ask him if he's married or seeing anyone.
No, I'm just, you know, footloose, fancy free.
Are you asking in general or for your yourself?
I'm engaged.
You're engaged. Oh, just, okay. Just
still
checking. All right, yes, hi. Wait, are you the woman with the size 10 or you are? You are, okay.
I'd like to be his bodyguard, though.
You'd like to be my bodyguard? Yeah.
Really?
Yes, I could be his bodyguard.
You look like you knocked somebody out over there, too.
Hello. I'd like to know where you were born and raised at.
I was born in Texas, right outside of Dallas. You know, cowboy fan, a little place called Terrell. Yeah.
All right, you wish you was from good old New York. I know. Hi. Mr. Tie-Dye, yes.
Hi.
Nice to meet you, Ricki. I'm
nice
from Australia.
So. Welcome.
Thank you.
Good eye, Mike.
Good eye, Mike.
You know, it's okay to be yourself.
First three shrimps on the barbie there, Mike.
What?
Where you got your inspiration from when you started comedy?
Good question.
I got my inspirations from just love, from watching, you know, all the cats, Richard Pryor, Eddie Murphy, Whoopi Goldberg, Robin Williams, all the cats, you know, and then just taking my own thing and putting it together, putting it down.
Yes, ma'am.
Can I get a hug?
A hug?
Uh-huh.
Yeah. You got a hug for her?
Yeah.
Okay, go right on up there. Raising ladies in the crowd.
God bless you. Nice to have you, sir.
Thank you.
I will just ask Jamie, I'm an up-and-coming comedian myself. What tips do you have for me, you know, in order to
stick with what you know. If you're funny, whatever you got that's funny, get out there, get in the clubs, do it 7 days a week like I did. Get out, it doesn't matter.
I got a good tip for you. Sell some shoes.
Yeah.
It worked for him. Jamie Foxx, thank you so
thank
much
you.
For coming by. We love having
thank
you here.
You.
Come back soon, please.
All right.
How about a hand for Jamie Foxx? I've given them a total makeover and have sung their praise, but now even I'm at a loss for words. When we come back, you're going to witness my wacky staff trying to outdo each other with Ricki's silly staff stuff. Don't go away. There's a lot more to come. Hey, Jamie, would you sign our wall? Michael Bergin is coming up. Today is Fun Friday, and it's going to be wilder than ever because you're about to see something that you have never seen before. In fact, I have never seen it before. My staff is going to be doing Ricki's silly staff stuff. I can't wait. All right. First up, I do believe we have our associate producer, Jenny, and she is going to be, get this, guys, I know you can't believe it, she's going to be rollerblading with a water bottle on her head without spilling it. All right, Jenny, anytime you're ready. Woo! Woo! Oh, yeah! Great job! Woo! She goes backwards, too! Woo! Oh. Did that guy in the front row trip you? He tripped you, I saw that. Not fair. Boy, I didn't know having a flat head was a talent. That's great. Thank you. Thank you, Jenny. Thank you. And next we have Bill, who's one of our production assistants, and he actually gets, he flips his hands over his head while holding his hands. Okay. We have it in slow motion. Let's watch. Oh. Youch. Okay, next we have Kirsten, who is one of our travel coordinators. Hi, Kirsten.
Hi.
Okay, now this is your television debut, I would imagine,
yes,
and
yes.
Your mother must be so proud. Okay, you're going to roll your tongue completely over. Did you catch it? Did you catch it? Wow. Thank you. Good job. I'll bet she's fun to have at parties. Okay. Next we have Mansoor. Mansoor. Here he comes. Okay. Wait, let me tell him. Okay, he can juggle, but that's not all. He can also do his Dizzy Gillespie impersonation. Can you believe the talent on our staff? It's unbelievable. All right, next we have Shari, our talent coordinator. Hi, Shari. Okay. Now this I cannot do. You're going to recite the states in our union alphabetically. And you're going to do it fast?
In 20 seconds.
In 20 seconds. Okay, let's put 20 seconds on the clock. Ready, set, go.
Alaska, Arizona, Arkansas, California, Colorado, Connecticut, Delaware, Florida, Georgia, Hawaii, Idaho, Illinois, Indiana, Iowa, Kansas, Kentucky, Louisiana, Maine, Maryland, Massachusetts, Michigan, Minnesota, Mississippi, Missouri, Montana, Nebraska, Nevada, New Hampshire, New Jersey, New Mexico, New York, North Carolina, North Dakota, Ohio, Oklahoma, Oregon, Pennsylvania, Rhode Island, South Carolina, South Dakota, Tennessee, Texas, Utah, Vermont, Virginia, Washington, West Virginia, Wisconsin.
Victoria, come on out and join us. She's also an associate producer here. Hi. I understand that you're going to recite the Greek alphabet.
Yes.
Oh, I can do that too.
Okay, well, do you want to like a compete, you know, here?
Is there anything else to it besides reciting the Greek alphabet?
Well, you know, lighting a match. This brings back memories, though. But while, you know, holding a match and...
And setting fire to the studio? No.
No.
Okay, so you're going to do it before the match burns down. You're going to recite the whole alphabet.
Yes.
Okay. All right.
Okay.
Hit it.
Alpha, beta, gamma, delta, epsilon, zeta, eta, theta, iota, kappa, lambda, mu, nu, xi, omicron, pi, rho, sigma, tau, epsilon, phi, chi, psi, omega.
Easy.
Easy.
I can do that. I'll try it too. All right. Do I get to light the match myself?
Yeah. You
okay.
Can.
All right. You ready? Wait. Now I don't have. You have to hold my stuff.
Okay.
All right. Root for me, guys. Zeta, eta, theta, iota, kappa, lambda, mu, nu, xi, omicron, pi, rho, sigma, tau, epsilon, phi, chi, psi, omega! Take a bow with me! Don't go away because we come back. It is the new man on the beach, beach babe Michael Bergin is up next. Stay tuned! Are guaranteed to be hot, hot, hot. Why? We'll take a look at Baywatch newcomer Jack J.D. Darius. Nightwatch's newest babe, Michael Bergin.
Thank you.
Oh my God.
It's all implants.
You're
It's all airbrushed.
No, seriously, no. You really work hard.
Implants.
What do you do to keep your body in shape?
I do a lot of things. I do about 2 sit-ups, 3 push-ups.
Come on, seriously,
for those of us who struggle with weight. I'm on the 2 push-up, 3 sit-up plan. Every night, it works. then you work up a big appetite and it makes you hungry.
So were you always looking that good? I mean, did you ever go through an ugly phase in life?
I was always ugly.
No, you weren't. We have pictures to prove it. I'm going to call you on it right now. That's look how cute he was.
That's me?
That, I think, is you.
Oh, that's me.
Adorable. Oh, so cute. All right, I got to ask
looking
you what everyone wants to know. Now, I'm asking for everyone else because I'm happily married, but are you single? Are you available?
I'm single, yeah. I'm available. Who's available? Anyone available?
I think most everyone, even if they're not available, they'll admit they're available right now. So
my mother's not available.
Your mother's in the audience?
Yeah. There's my father.
Hi.
Do you want the red face? Yeah. It's his birthday today.
It is? Happy birthday, Dad. Great to have you here. You must be so proud. Yeah. And you're doing so great. I mean, can we talk about Baywatch? How's it going there? Are you having fun?
Oh, I'm having a blast. It's so much. It's a dream job. I mean, just acting is a dream job, but I mean, outside on the beach.
With all those beautiful
with
women.
It's fun.
And they
it's fun.
Play practical jokes, I understand. They pull some tricks on you?
Yeah. I pull tricks on them first, but it all started one day. I was fooling around. I have my red lifeguard trunks on, and I have the Speedos underneath. That's the way we wear them. And on the butt, it says Baywatch. So I'm fooling around, I pull my red trunks down, and I'm showing like Baywatch, taking pictures. And Carmen Electra comes up to me, and she goes, whoop. She pulls them down in front of 200 people during lunch. Everyone
Uh-oh.
Lost their appetite.
Yeah. All right, what about Jack Nicholson? I understand you met him, and you were a little starstruck.
Yeah, you know what? When I first started modeling, I came out to New York City, and I was naive to the whole business, and Jack Nicholson was the first one of the first celebrities I've met. I think he was not the first, actually. I don't know. I went to there's another model with my agency, and he was having a Christmas party, and he was taking acting classes, and he became friends with his acting coach, and his acting coach was good friends with Jack Nicholson. So him having this Christmas party, Jack Nicholson was in town. He shows up. There's only 30 people in this like loft apartment. And he walks through the door, and he's Jack Nicholson, and he's got 2 blondes on this arm and a blonde on this arm. I was starstruck, very starstruck.
So did you introduce yourself?
Yeah, I did. There's only like 2 tables in the place. He's at one table, just like telling jokes and just being Jack, and everyone's laughing. I'm at the other table with my 2 modeling agents. I'm like, oh my God, there's Jack. Oh my God, I have to say hi. I have to shake his hand. And it's like, after half an hour, I finally got up and said, I'm going to shake his hand. I went over there, I went up to him, and I go, hi, I'm Jack Nicholson. Because in my mind, for half an hour, I didn't know how to say. I was going to say, hi, my name is Michael Bergin, nice to meet you, Jack Nicholson. Jack Nicholson, my name is Michael Bergin. You know, I didn't know what to say.
Right.
So I ended up getting confused, and I said, hi, I'm Jack Nicholson. And he's like, oh, really? I thought I was.
Well, he handled it well.
It was funny. I felt like a jerk, and I just went back to my table.
Well, there's no forgetting that you are Michael Bergin, and it's great to see you here. I wish you the best with the show,
Thank
with the modeling,
much.
With everything. It's
Thank
great
you.
To see you. Thank
Thanks.
You.
Thanks for having me.
Michael Bergin, everyone. Hey, guess what? It's getting close to the time when some lucky person in our audience will win a beautiful honeymoon. Could it be this couple? Is it this couple? It could be anyone sitting here today. Do you know who you are yet? Anybody? When we return, one of the hottest hits of the summer is performed by the anything but shy Diana King. Stay with us. Good job.
Say a little prayer for you. May I go say a little prayer for you?
Hi, Ricki. Happy Fun Friday from St. Louis and me, Christina Roberg.
I guess you guys all got t-shirts from Claiborne. Yeah. All right. And now, with her current smash, I Say a Little Prayer from her Think Like a Girl CD, please welcome Diana King.
A very happy birthday in Australia for November the 15th. I love you very, very much and I hope you have a very super day.
Lucky couple in our audience will win a beautiful romantic honeymoon. But what we haven't told you guys is that that couple is not even married yet. Today, someone in our audience is about to get herself an engagement ring. Woo! What do you think? I think we have waited long enough. Take a look at this while I tell you a little bit about the lucky couple. Once upon a time, there was a cute baby girl who, like every other baby, grew up, lost her teeth and blossomed into a sweet young lady and became the prettiest maiden at the prom. One day, her Prince Charming entered her life. He was a good boy who grew into a handsome young man. Today, they grew into quite a couple. Does this story end here? No way. Now her Prince Charming has a question to ask her. Where is the princess? There she is. Hi. You okay? Why don't you go on up there, Erica? Erica, you had no idea, huh?
No.
You thought you were a VIP audience member, huh? You got yourself some free tickets. Well, everyone gets free tickets. They're free here at the Ricki Lake Show. Everyone is a VIP member. But you are special today, and your special someone is back there. Let's meet him. Kyle, come on out.
time do you remember me? Over the past 2.5 years, you've been generous and trusting with me and shared your life with me. So I brought you here today, in front of God and in front of everybody, to tell you that I loved you.
Love you too.
And I want you to be my wife.
Yes.
Surprise, guess what? You are going on a honeymoon after the fact. So you better get married quick. You are going to be honeymooning at the beautiful Mount Airy Lodge, guys. The honeymoon capital of the world, the Pocono Mountains of Pennsylvania. You will enjoy the Crystal Palace suite with your own private pool in the privacy of your room. A heart-shaped jacuzzi tub for two, fireplace and sauna. Included, you got gourmet dining, top name entertainment, dancing, and much, much more. Everybody sing with me. At Mount Airy Lodge, all you have to bring is your love of everything. Yay! That was such a great moment, and you know, it's a bummer that none of your family is here to share this with you. Mm-hmm. But you know what? They are here! Come on out, guys! Nephews, brothers, sisters, congratulations. Have a great time. Have a wonderful honeymoon. And thank you for sharing this with us. Thank you, guys. More fun Friday when we come back. And if nothing else, I am sure that you are convinced that Fridays are for F-U-N fun. I'd like to thank all of my guests for being with us today. Jamie Foxx, Michael Bergin, Diana King, and my wacky staff. Thank you, guys. Have a great weekend. Be safe and have fun. Hey, I'll bet you thought it was over, huh? Well, no way. Here with her latest release, Lies, Diana King. See you Monday.
I wanna realize things you say will make you fade away. Ba 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 ba. Last night in a club, you want a girl to do the rubber dub dub. Short dress and long curly hair. Don't deny, cause I.